fate, chance, destiny. Call it what you will. Life is anything but predictable. Three unhappy secretaries.
Her own fantastic dream. Oh dear, not be called greedy. What nonsense! I merely wish to be elegant rather than seedy. You'd become a prey to many modern ills. And you'll succumb to that modern menace. Pills. Don't be silly. You'd have to take narcotics. Antibiotics. Antihistamine. And Dramamine. For your colitis, bursitis, neuritis, gastritis, and all the other types of itis.
I can't think of it at the moment.
Oh, don't be a bore. And you would need a rescue.
You've been expecting me.
I don't believe I know you. There must be some mistake.
I doubt it. Aren't you the contestant who sent in an entry to Lavery Brothers, the world's foremost manufacturer of products for cleaner living?
Oh, yes. I wrote a slogan.
Come on, girls!
I do soap that Lavery makes, because Lavery makes the most Lavery flicks.
Lavery.
Lavery.
Lavery. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Well, miss, it is my pleasure as the representative of Lavery Brothers, the world's foremost manufacturer of products for cleaner living, to inform you that in our history-making contest, you are the winner of the first prize of $64,664,640.64.
I can't believe it! How did you know me? How did you find me?
It was very simple. Wherever you are, whatever you may be about, wherever you may be hiding, fate will ferret you out.
I can't believe it.
What a wonderful
I can't
now, miss, if you'll be good enough to accompany me, there are a few details that require your presence at the offices of Lavery Brothers, the world's foremost...
Etc. Come on!
Miss, but isn't there someone here who recently submitted a manuscript to Button, Burjhardt, and Biking?
Oh, yes, I did.
Well, Miss, as the representative, I have important news for you. Your manuscript has been accepted.
Oh, dear! Please pinch me! I'm awake! There's a mark!
Our editors report that your book is charming, original, subtle, penetrating, and daring.
The more phrase, the better!
The more cliches, the better!
Everything I ever wanted, and only a few minutes ago, is nothing but an unknown writer!
If I may, I should like to go over a few points in our contract for your approval.
Oh, yes! Please do!
Agreement. Agreement by and between the author and or proprietor party of the first part here and after called the publishers, etc., etc. Party of the second part here and after called the publishers respecting, yada, 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 here and after called said work. Agreed! The publishers agree to publish said work in volume, form, and sound price that they deem best within months. Agreed. The publishers agree to pay the author a royalty of 0% of the amount which the publishers charge while copies sold of works less copies returned. Agreed.
Agreed. I'm terribly confused. Don't you think I need a literary agent?
That shouldn't be necessary. Everybody knows that publishing is a gentleman's affair. In the meantime, Messrs. Button, Burjhardt, and Biking are waiting to meet their latest discovery. The car is waiting.
Go!
program, miss. Miss. Pardon me, miss. Pardon me, miss. There's a telegram.
Oh, excuse me. I didn't see you.
Police, I'm here. Thank you.
Dear Secretary Number One, that's me! I'm his number one!
Try to be conscientious and obliging, and as you know, that can be frightfully inconvenient. I'm expected to be prepared for anything and anyone, and so I have something up my sleeve for every type of client. A license for you, a diploma for you, a bequest for you, admissions, citations, certificates, and commissions. I'm delegated to deliver them. But it's dreadfully discouraging when I get cases like these. They ask for the one thing in the world they think they want most. And then what happens?
I'm tired of the routine of spinster stuff.
this job's superb. I did it.